Hello friends, welcome back to My Exam Coaching Classes. Today we are going to study chapter number 5 of your mathematics, that is arithmetic progression, and we are going to learn what are the important things we should remember so that we can solve the arithmetic progression related questions very fast in your board exam. So there are some tricks, there are some important formula we have to remember, there are some shortcut methods we have to study. By using all these things, you can easily solve any problem asked from chapter arithmetic progression in your board exam. Okay, so we will focus on the main, the important things which we need to remember from this chapter. So we all know what is an arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression is nothing but a sequence. In a sequence, except the first term, the other all other terms are obtained when you add a fixed constant with its previous term. So for example, if I write a sequence like this, first term is a, and then I add a common difference with the first term. Suppose I am adding d with the first term, I will get the next term a plus d, and with this a plus d, if I add one more d, I will get a plus 2d, and with this a plus 2d, if I add one more d, I will get a plus 3d, and like this I am getting a sequence. This sequence is nothing but an arithmetic progression. So what actually happens, arithmetic progression is a sequence in which except the first term, you can start the first term from anywhere, except the first term all other terms are obtained by adding a fixed constant number to its previous term. That fixed constant d is called common difference. Okay, so when we talk about the common difference can be positive, common difference can be negative, even common difference can be sometimes zero also. For example, if I take a sequence like this, 3, then I am adding 2 to 3, I will get 5, 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 2, 9, 9 plus 2, 11, and I am getting a sequence like this. So what actually happens, except the first term, you can see all other differences are what? 2, 5 minus 3, I will get a 2 here. 7 minus 5, I'll get 2 here. 9 minus 7, I'll get 2 here. 11 minus 9, I'll get 2 here. So the previous term added with its common difference, you are getting the next term. So here you can see this number 2, 2, 2, 2 are common, and which is called the common difference. And in this case, in this AP, the common difference D is positive. Isn't it? For example, if I take a series like this, I am starting from 17 and I am subtracting 3, so I will get 14, again I am subtracting 3, I will get 11, again I am subtracting 3, I will get 8, and again 5, and it goes like this. So after some numbers I will get it into a negative number. So here you can see the common difference is I am adding minus 3 to 17, so I am getting 14, and again I am adding minus 3 to 14, I am getting 11, again I am adding minus 3 to 11, I am getting 8. So what is the common difference I am getting here? The common difference is here, the always remember the common difference is taken when you subtract the term from its next term, the term from its next term. So you have to subtract 14 minus 17, I will get minus 3 here. I'm 11 minus 14, I'll get minus 3 here. 8 minus 11, I'll get minus 3 here. 5 minus 8, I'll get minus 3 here. So what is the common difference here? The common difference is negative number. So D can be negative. So suppose I'm writing a sequence like this. I'm getting 7, 7, 7, 7, 7 like that. So what actually happens? 7 plus 0, 7. 7 plus 0, 7. 7 plus 0, 7. 7 plus 0, 7. When 0 is added up with every term, its next term is obtained. So in this case, D is equal to 0. So what actually I want to tell you is, the common difference can be positive, the common difference can be negative, or even sometimes the common difference can be zero also. So that is arithmetic progression. So A is called the first term. This term A, that is called first term, and to denote that first term we will write it as A1, and D is the common difference. D is the common difference. And these are the number of terms, first term, second term, third term, fourth term, like that. How many terms are there? N terms are there, suppose. So nth term is denoted by an. Nth term is denoted by an. So these are all the important things you have to remember before getting into the exam hall. What is A1, what is an, and what is D? D can be positive, D can be negative, D can be zero. A1 is nothing but A, the first term. The first term, to denote the first term, we write A1. And to denote the second term, we write A2, denote the third term, A3, A4, like that. And suppose there are n number of terms, so to denote the nth term, we will write it as AN. I hope you understood this. So this is the basic of arithmetic progression. Now we have to remember very important formula in this. So we have to study those formula, then it is easy for you to solve the questions based on arithmetic progression. So what are the important formula we have to study here? And then I'll give you some tricks. So the important formula is, what we have seen, we will write it here. We have seen the first term A, A1 is A itself. D is the common difference. D is the common difference. That common difference can be, you have already seen, it can be either positive, it can be negative, or even it can be sometimes zero also. So A1 you have seen, D you have seen. If it is a second term, you already will write, you will write A2, A3, A4 like that. And suppose there are n number of terms, so we will denote it as An. So An is nth term. You can say it is as nth term, or you can say, if nth term, that's the last term, so you can say it is a last term. Okay, the first term or last term. So what is the last term? How last term is obtained? For that we have a formula. An is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. One of the very important formula, students, you have to remember, this is the nth term. Nth term is obtained like this. Nth term, to find the nth term, what is the formula we are using? An is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. You can note it. So you understood A plus n minus 1 into D. What is A? A is your first term. What is n? Number of terms. How many terms are there? Don't confuse with the n and an. An is nth term and n is number of terms. For example, I'll tell you, I'm writing an AP. Let our AP is equal to 4, 7, 10, 13, 16, 19, 22, up to 22 I'm writing. Okay. So now, what is my first term? What is the common difference here? Common difference is 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. So common difference is 3. So here, what is the first term? A1. A1 is equal to A. That is 4. What is D? D is equal to 3 plus 3. And what is An? What is An? An is the last term. So An is 22. What is N? N is how many number of terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 are there. So N is equal to 7. So normally students confuse with the An and N. N stands for how many terms are there? 7 terms are there. So we'll take it as N is equal to 7. What is An indicates? An is, what is that nth term? Nth term is 22. So don't confuse with the N and An. Okay. Now if I ask you, what is A4 here? What is A4? So A4 means fourth term, first, second, third, fourth. So fourth is 13. So how fourth is obtained? Fourth is obtained by A4 is equal to, An is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. A plus n minus 1 into D. I want fourth term. So fourth term will be A plus. What is A here? 4. 4 plus n minus 1. How many n are there? Fourth term I want. So n is equal to 4. 4 minus 1, 3. 3 into D. D is how much? 3. 3 threes are 9. 9 plus 4, 13. So I'll get the fourth term, 13. Okay. So this is the way you will find out what is nth term. So this formula is very important for you, students. An is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. So that is the formula to find out what is nth term. Now what we are going to learn, we are going to study how to find the sum of first n terms of an AP. So next is sum of first n terms. Sum of first n terms of an AP. So sum of first term n terms of an AP is given by the formula, is denoted by Sn. Sum of first n terms. Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. This is one of the formula we can use. But here you can say, if I split this 2a, I can write it as what? If I write this 2a, I can write it as a plus a, 2a can be written as a plus a into plus n minus 1 into d. So you can see what I have written, only this 2a I have written a plus a, then n minus 1 into d, n minus 1 into d. But what we have written here, a plus n minus 1 into d equal to an, that is a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to an. So I can write it was a plus an. So here I can write this full term, I can write it as a plus an. So what is Sn? Sn is equal to n by 2 into a stands for what? The first term. That is first term plus an stands for what? Last term. An. Or you can say first term plus last term. Or so for detail you can write n by 2 into first term plus first term plus last term, or you can say nth term. So this is very important formula to find out the sum of first n terms of an AP. You can note it. Okay, can I remove it? Fine. So now we will see, sometimes questions are asked about consecutive numbers. Okay, so in that case, what strategy we will use to solve the problem in arithmetic progressions? So that is very important, students. Like for example, consecutive terms in AP, three consecutive terms in AP. Some questions are asked like three consecutive terms in AP. So when we talk about three consecutive terms, we will use three consecutive terms. So the three consecutive terms are taken as a minus d comma a comma a plus d. Always take it like this, then it will be easy for you to solve the questions. Whenever in the question three consecutive terms are in AP, like that it is given in your question, so take the consecutive terms as a minus d, a and a plus d. Okay, not it. So sometimes what happens, four consecutive terms are asked, four consecutive terms. Okay, so when you have four consecutive terms, when four consecutive terms are in AP, so normally we take that four consecutive terms as a minus 3d comma a minus d comma a plus d and a plus 3d. So this is the method of taking four consecutive terms in AP. Very important. And why should we take it like this? When we take a minus d plus a plus d, sum of three terms, this minus d and plus d will get cancelled, then you get a plus a equal to 3a, then it is easy for you to find out the value of a. So that is the reason we are taking all these things. Okay, four consecutive terms in AP, what does it mean? We will take a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus d and a plus 3d. So when you add all these things, this minus d and plus d, minus 3d and plus 3d, or minus d and plus d, all this get cancelled and you will have only a term. So you can easy to find out the value of a. Once you got the value of a, substitute the value of a, then you can find out the value of d also. So these are a lot of easy techniques used in the arithmetic progression. Okay, so five consecutive terms are in AP. Five consecutive terms are in AP means what? There are five consecutive terms are in AP. Five consecutive terms are in AP. So how you will use? You will use it as a minus 2d comma a minus d comma a, then a plus d and a plus 2d. So if you take this minus 2d plus 2d minus d plus d, all these things gets cancelled and you will get everything in terms of a. So it is easy for you to find out the value of a. Once you got the value of a, it is easy for you to substitute the value of a. Okay, so these are all the important techniques we use to solve the question when these terms are given in the question. Three consecutive terms are in AP, or four consecutive terms are in AP, or five consecutive terms are in AP, etc., etc. Okay, so that's all from the arithmetic progression chapter, students. This is the basic concept I have given to you. In the next video, what we are going to do is we are going to solve the important board questions which are asked in the previous 10 years of question papers. Okay, so kindly watch that video also. And students who are not prepared for our beautiful channel My Exam Coaching, I request you kindly subscribe today. And in the next video, I am uploading the important questions asked in the previous question papers and how questions are asked from arithmetic progression and as well as from other chapters also. So kindly subscribe. Okay, we will meet again with the new videos. Okay, bye bye, take care.